Okay, so here we have our fishy. As you can see, he's upside down. But he's still breathing okay, and he's swimming. He's been like this for a few days.
Can I talk now?
So we're going to see if we can help him out with a little operation on his swim bladder.
Hey, Daddy, can I say something?
Okay, you can say something. What do you want to say?
Hi, my fishy's upside down, and we can't feed him because he needs to fart.
He needs to fart, you think? Okay, that might be
it. Can I say something?
Okay, what do you want to say?
Our fish is upside down, and he's going up and down, kind of.
Yep. So we need to try and do something to help him.
And we have to feed him beans.
Peas. We tried that. It didn't work, so.
You can see there's a few little peas in the bottom of the tank there, which haven't been eaten, so that hasn't worked.
Anyway, we'll see how we go. We'll put him in, try and get him out and put him under a bit of an anaesthetic, and then see if we can work out where his swim bladder is.
I'm going to do one again, Daddy.
I've also made this light box here, which is just a cardboard box with a little hole cut out in it, which we're going to put this torch. Jams in there. Hoping if we take him into a dark room and put the fish on top of here, we might be able to see where the where his bubble is inside of his swim bladder to help us try and pop the needle in the right spot. So yeah, cool thing. We'll see if it works, hopefully later. Okay, so now we're gonna try and catch the little fella. Okay.
Don't squeeze him. I'm gonna touch him.
So this is water mixed with a few drops of clove oil.
Yeah.
Well, the website said about 6 to 8 drops per gallon. So a gallon's just under 4 liters, so that's about 2 liters in there, so I'll pop 4 drops in. So I'll leave him for a while and see if he slows down his breathing and goes to sleep.
Night-night. See you in the morning.
Okay, so it's been about 12 minutes or so, and I think he's starting to get pretty sleepy. I just gently pinch his fin with my fingernail there, and you see you're not getting much of a response, so he's not really responding to pain, so that's good. All right, let's get him out and have a look at him.
Okay. Oh my God, you look so funny. Okay.
I think right there is where he is. See the lights coming through here?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's where his swim bladder is.
That went on my lip.
Yuck. Just make out the little bit where the light's coming through. So I think that's where his swim bladder is. That's what we're gonna aim. Okay.
You marked it?
Yep. Just gonna pour a bit of water over his gills. There we go.
Now I'm gonna dip the needle.
22 gauge.
Oh, that looks so soft.
Beverage down. Oh, there we go, so we're pulling out air. Now I've got resistance, so I've pulled out about 2 mils of air. and no more will come out, so.
What are they doing? He's not breathing.
He's about 2 mils of air.
What are they doing? He's not breathing.
Right. Let's get him back in the water and see how he goes.
Don't touch the heel.
Watch it.
Yep.
Okay, put him back in.
Let the fish free.
Put him under the water, so he's getting water on his gills.
He's trying to get away because he's falling on his face. Please be alive, please be alive. What is he doing?
He just fell down.
He's sleeping.
He's sleeping.
Keep him under here for a bit longer.
Maybe that spell
for like 20 minutes or 10.
Use the spell to make him sleep.
Or 6.
Wake up,
fishy.
Maybe
that fishy spell flying.
And here's our little fella today. He's 3 days after his little operation. You can see he's upright at least. He did lose a bit of buoyancy and he kind of sinks a bit now. But he's able to get going once he swims, as you can see. So it's actually gotten better. When he first popped him back in the tank, he sank like a stone. But now, yeah, if he swims, he's quite easily able to get to the top. So we'll call our little operation a success at this stage. There he is, happy enough. So I'll nudge him with the cleaner.